heads on from the homesteaders on down of a place that they call Oshodo. A place so dismissed it could only exist in memories and black and white photos. A Wyoming place where the beef cattle graze and the boys become men at young ages. The buzzards fly high and the jackrabbits hide in the cedars, choke cherries and sages. When the grass grew up high, my brother and I would get sent out to start the hay season. As the sun beat down mean, we prepared the machines by fueling, repairing and greasing. The tractor we had been run by my dad and purchased by his dad before him. So we were the third generation that heard that old Johnny Popper each morning. The old thing was a heap with a rickety sweep for picking up bales from the meadow. When you lifted the hay, the whole tractor would sway if you weren't sitting perfectly level. I'd head out and back with a load for the stack, and I'd lift it up top to my brother. He'd arrange on the stack the load I had just packed while I headed out for another. With the stack 10 tiers high, I decided to try to see how many bales she could carry. I started grabbing one more than the load from before. That's when things began to get hairy. My brother yelled down, "Stop your messing around. 14 bales is too much for that tractor." I yelled right back, "Keep your mind on the stack. 15 is the number I'm after." The rear wheels were lifting. But I made it back with that load to the stack, just clutching and grinding and shifting. I lifted the load and started to pull forward. The hydraulics were pushed to their limit. The frame began to bend and it looked like the end of the tractor and the guy sitting in it. As the tractor went or I had no place to go, jumping out wasn't much of an option. There was one thing I knew when this ride was all through, my undies would need a good washing. As it slammed to its side, I heard my brother cry, or was it the sound of his laughter? While stacking some hay on that Wyoming day, came the wreck of my grandpa's old tractor. Does anyone know just how far it is home when you know there's an ass whooping coming? I was walking as slow as my old boots would go, but my brother, he took off a running. When I finally walked in, my brother did grin. I always knew he was their favorite. I knew it as a fact and I was okay with that. It bothered me more that he knew it. I hoped that my mother would calm down my pa, but I didn't have the guts to go ask her. Then later that night, Papa tanned my behind for the wreck of my grandpa's old tractor.